The tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on. Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions. Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. The new story beat fit the story perfectly. I changed the story, and with that, the dark place changed. The federal agent had come here looking for answers. All he found was a fate worse than death.
It's bad luck to be on this case. The cult can get you anywhere with that black magic shit. Let the day shift handle it. What happened, anyway?
Some fed came looking for the cult, but it was a trap. A satanic blood sacrifice.
Anyone who gets involved with the cult, they're next. I heard their leader is this famous writer. Alan Wake? Their unholy motherfucking messiah.
Sounds like a load of bull.
The blood trail disappeared under the rubble. I had a feeling something was waiting there. Another echo lingered here, a source of inspiration.
These tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books. That Wake was even involved somehow, under a false identity. Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way. But I was desperate, and it felt right for the story. The plot element I found would drive the story forward. I was making my way deeper into the story. I could imagine this murder cult performing their macabre acts beyond the collapsed tunnel. The cultists laid the Casey novel onto the altar with reverence. A twisted Bible. Water was gone. The way forward was open.
Breaker, in case you don't remember again.
I know, Tim. I'm remembering more now.
It's good to hear, man.
How's your search for Mr. Door going?
It's not great. This dream we're in, putting a lot of roadblocks in my way.
The sketch you have does look like the door I know. The talk show host.
All I know is the door has something to do with what's happening to me. And he knows. That I know. He's like some sadistic mastermind torturing me.
So you think this is a dream?
I'm not ruling it out. You know, my dreams have always been incredibly vivid. They feel real until the second I wake up. In the dreams, I'm often someone else, a different person. With a different name, living a different life in a different world. It's alternate realities, maybe. But certain things don't change. Like Dor.
is fading like a dream. I must hold on to it. I remember an awful beacon in the darkness, a scene of a ritualistic murder site in the subway tunnels. It's the previous draft of my writing. Must be. I've been trying to shape the dark place around me, but so much fades away. Even my memory of the process, washed away by dark waves. But some things remain. The darkest, nastiest elements, like the murder site. It's my goal, a stepping stone to travel deeper to escape. Write a narrative that takes me there. Casey will lead me to it.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play. I could figure this out on the plot board. The new scene I had found was important for the story. Couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene. The scene had changed.
Hello? Anyone there?
Dead. This thread fit the scene. Poured the gasoline over the train car. An iron cage that would soon become a coffin.
This is where the history of the cult gets genuinely disturbing. The cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels. They lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. It was locked from the other side. I had a new beat for the story. The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now. Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible. My path was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me. The Echoing Hall had a story to tell. Setting. Changed into the murder cult's hideout.
The ritual to lead you on.
The Fed had witnessed something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site. The cultists were close now, a dark presence rising from the depths. A new story thread.
This is the ritual to lead you on. Your friends will meet him when you're
awake.
Turns out the cultists weren't the only ones using the tunnels. Hidden graffiti signs marked secret routes. I kept hearing whispers around burn barrels of an underground society of mystic outsiders with hidden knowledge. Typical New York.
Wake.
Christmas tree for all the good it did him.
The Drifters had scrawled their symbol on the wall. A secret for those in the know. Dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. I could get through. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, hunting me. Somehow the victim's heart was the key. Something had shifted. I felt an overwhelming closeness to home.
An FBI agent? Who are you?
What is this? Who are you?
She can hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI.
Help me. This is Alan Wake. I'm trapped here. The dark place. Under Cauldron Lake.
Cauldron Lake. Who are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm making progress, but I'm in danger. The Dark Presence. Help me. Please, help me.
I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed outside Parliament Tower, where I had lived with Alice. It was out there, waiting for me.